Lepsje vroebel. Garst. What? Lepsje? Lepsje vroebel.
I'm just laughing at the saying, not at your pronunciation.
Garstchi. Nish. Gowom. Gowom from Gowomki.
Gowomki as the meal is the name of the meal, but Gowom or Gowembi or Gowomki literally are pigeons.
I know, yeah, because you're right, right? It's pigeons in blanket, right? Or something like that. Is that what you're saying?
Gowomki or Gowomki, just little pigeons. There are no blankets there.
No?
Only cabbage.
Okay, because we have the same similar thing and we call it.
Niño
en vueltos,
right?
Niño en vueltos.
Even worse, babies in blankets. Zaviniente Gigi, yummy.
Okay, so something about the pigeons being on the ceiling, right? Like dahu, sort of dach, like the roof.
Yes.
The roof, I mean. So I mean that they're not on the ceiling. They're not on the thing.
Where do they go?
Niche. I know this. I don't have it right, but I think it's mejor un pájaro en mano que cien volando.
Yeah!
Yes!
So it means that it's better to have a sparrow in your hand than a pigeon on the roof.
Yeah. We say mejor un pájaro en mano.
Better one bird in your hand than
Polish.
One flying.
The
right?
One flying, yeah, exactly.
Okay. Lepszy ptak w garści niż latający or something.
Yeah,
like
something
that.
Like that. Mądrzejsze?
Yep.
Jajko od kury. So is mądrzejsze related to mądre?
Yeah. More intelligent.
Okay, more intelligent.
Intelligenter.
So this says here it's more intelligent than an egg. Something jajko.
Yeah, then od egg kury. Is intelligenter.
So the egg's more intelligent?
Yeah.
What is odd is
than.
Than odd. Mm-hmm. Than kury. Mm-hmm. What is kury? It's an animal, right?
Okay. You should know this from people. I tell him that's a kura makes.
Yeah, but you're saying that the egg's more intelligent than the chicken.
Yeah. So what do you think it means?
It cannot be that the older person is more intelligent because the egg is the younger person.
So it cannot be or it can't
no,
be?
No, it cannot be.
Well, egg is not really intelligent, is it? It's not even a full-on being.
I don't know by now. You know, you're your weird kashas and...
You will tell it to a child. What do you think? The egg is smarter than the chicken. I know what you should do. Go to your room.
Okay, so it's actually, you know, that the chicken is more intelligent. Have you said this to Vigo? Have you said this to Vigo? What is the one that he said about to me? Goop, 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 goop.
Tata nie zgada głupot.
He said that to me. She taught him that. Najstarsi górale nie pamiętają. So the górale don't remember. The górale people don't remember.
But najstarsi, what does it mean?
Najstarsi.
You know, stary.
Ah, so an old górale never forgets.
No. The oldest.
The oldest górale doesn't remember.
Yeah.
So what does that mean?
Something that even the oldest górale don't remember.
Ah, okay, I get it. Like when it's something that you cannot recall.
Something that was long time ago.
Okay, you would say that. Yeah. Okay, I get it.
But
why the górale?
Apparently they're very old.
Or they remember everything.
Yeah, I don't know why it is. Why it's like that, but maybe...
Tell us in the comments if you know.
What's the origin of it, but...
Yeah. So... Raz na wozie, raz pod wozem.
This is very old.
On top of something, once under.
Now it's a good moment to tell you that wóz is like a carriage.
With a carriage, like for the horses.
Yeah.
Aha. So.
Sometimes you're on top of it.
Sometimes you're under it. So it means that like. Just sometimes there are better days or something like this, kind of like you're
fortune
right? Like,
changes.
Okay.
Oh, that one is good.
Okay.
This is what people say to children a lot.
Słuchać uchem, a nie brzuchem. Okay. Listen.
Yeah.
I know brzuchem is from brzuch, right?
I would say to Vigo, słuchaj uchem, a nie brzuchem. I would not say.
Ah, wait. Listen is ucho.
Uh-huh.
So listen with the ear. Not with the belly?
Yeah. It just means when they're not listening to you. Yeah. It's just they probably created this because it rhymes. Oh, this will be hard though.
Tonące brzydwy się chwyta. So, chwyta is that from cord? Chwyty?
From what?
From cords? Chwyty?
Oh, similar. Yeah. So, how did you know that word?
I know. Chwyty means cords, right?
Chwytać means to grab or hold on to something.
Uh-huh. So the chords, I guess, come from precision of hand,
yeah,
right?
Exactly, or something. How you hold the guitar.
So let me see. Bzhidve. Bzhidve.
This you for sure know. Bzhidva is what they used to use to shave men. This.
Like straight razor. Straight razor. Tononte is drowning?
Yeah, someone's drowning.
Drowning. Straight razor?
Tononte means someone that is drowning.
Yeah.
Would, and then the rest of the sentence means would grab or hold on to a shaving razor.
Yeah, like you would do anything, yes. Right? To survive.
Even
or to...
you would be like, if you're desperate, you would do anything.
Okay.
This is our survival instinct, you know, in Poland.
Polish people, feisty Polish people, I like it.
Okay, this is the last one. Okay. And this has a very heavy cultural meaning.
Okay, so babas vosu koniom ije.
This is an L.
Ah.
Lżej.
Lżej?
Yeah.
Lżej. Mm-hmm. So baba is baba is from our grandma?
Like grandma, but baba in general means just an old woman.
Old woman, okay. So old woman vosu with a carriage.
Off the carriage.
Off the carriage.
Yeah, she comes off the carriage.
Okay, off the carriage. Koniom J.
Koń? You remember?
From stone?
No, koń, not kamień.
Ah, the horse.
Yeah.
So, baba, off. So woman that is off the carriage, the horse is what? Is happy? Is
yes. It literally means when the old woman leaves the carriage, it's easier for the horses.
Yeah, I agree.
What do you think it means? Like, it's like, about women. It's about women, that your life without a woman is easier. Would you agree?
I don't agree. They keep me alive. She keeps me alive.
That's true. Statistics will tell you that men who are married live longer, happier lives.
Poles are not those people. They will show they love you by yelling at you and telling you to put on warm clothes or to take your vitamins because they don't want to outlive you. Yes, it is true, guys. Seriously. One thing I'm not gonna do on this channel is have sexist jokes.
Yeah, I will do that.
Again.
Boom! That's all, guys. That's the end of the episode. I hope you liked it and I hope you learned something in Polish and about Polish culture.
It was really cool. It was really, really cool. I was very scared because, like I said, I've been cheating my way through this YouTube channel.
Yes.
I haven't, like I said, I admitted it. But it was very interesting. I discovered that many of the sayings are actually have like a background in you know,
rural life,
you know.
And many are universal. Many are just exist also in your language or in English and stuff like
I
that.
I wonder if Vigo is gonna say, you know, once the bots go to sleep. The humans party, you know what I mean? Like, what is in the future?
I don't think those change. I think he's gonna be saying, no one is gonna blow in my porridge.
Guys,
no one will blow in his porridge.
As long as she's around. Guys, I hope you liked the episode. Don't forget to subscribe, thumbs up, and we'll see you. And please.
Send him some language challenges, maybe.
Most importantly, write something nice for Vigo's mom that she's finally back with us in the channel. And we have to... Maybe,
no pressure.
Maybe I should say, maybe we all should write to her boss so that they cut her hours so that she can be more on this
channel. Pay me the same, please.
I'll pay you the same.
Bye.